Good morning, students. This video is for chapter number 3, Jainism and Buddhism. Here, we will study about the sources for Jainism and Buddhism, causes for the rise, early life of Mahavir and Buddha, and their teachings. So let us start with the sources. For Jainism, the main source are the Angas, which were compiled in Jain Council. It is generally believed that whatever Mahavir taught after gaining omniscience was compiled by his disciples in 12 parts called the Angas. The Angas were written in Prakrit. Buddhism. Jatakas and Tripitakas are the main source of information for Buddhism. Tripitakas, or the three baskets, comprise of Sutta Pitak, Vinay Pitak, and Abhidhamma Pitak. The Jatakas deal with the previous birth of Lord Buddha, both in human and animal form. So here you can see the image of the Angas, and this is of the Jatakas. Causes for the rise of Jainism and Buddhism. Complex religious rituals. Religious ceremonies had become very expensive, which were beyond the means of the ordinary people. Some priests hardly realized the sufferings of the common man. Rigid caste system, the division of society into Brahmins, Kshatriyas, Vaishyas, and Shudras had become rigid. It did not allow any social mobility. Agricultural economy, killing of animals to perform sacrifices, was against the interest of the farmers in the Gangetic Valley. Both Jainism and Buddhism preached non-violence and were against animal sacrifices. Difficult language. Sanskrit was considered a sacred language. The priestly class gave discourses and chanted mantras in this language, which the common people found difficult to understand. Lastly, there were liberal rulers like Bimbisar and Ajatshatru who supported Jainism and Buddhism. Early life of Mahavir. Mahavir was born in a Kshatriya family in Kundagram near Vaishali. He left home at the age of 30 in search of knowledge and attained supreme knowledge at the age of 42 and became a jain or a conqueror, that is, one who has conquered his desires. Early life of Buddha. He was born at Lumbini near Kapilvastu. he came across four great sights, which were the old man, a sick man, a dead man, and an ascetic. These sights moved him, and he left home at the age of 29 in search of knowledge. This event in the history of Buddhism is famous as Mahabhinishkraman, or the Great Renunciation. He got enlightenment at the age of 35 at Bodh Gaya. After this, he became Buddha, or the Enlightened One. When he began preaching his religion, he gave his first sermon at Deer Park in Sarnath near Varanasi in presence of five ascetics. This event in the history of Buddhism is known as Dharma Chakra Pravartan, or the turning of the wheel of sacred law. Teachings of Mahavir. Mahavir laid great emphasis on Ahimsa. A Jain householder has to take the following five vows: Ahimsa, that is non-violence; Astey, or non-stealing; Satya, not telling a lie; Aparigraha, not possessing property; and Brahmacharya, practicing chastity. Mahavir preached that the ultimate goal of man is to attain freedom from the worldly bonds, or attain moksha, which could be obtained by following the three ratnas, that is, right faith, right knowledge, and right conduct. Like the Hindus, the Jains also believe in the karma theory, where one is considered to be responsible for his own actions. Salvation. Like the Hindus, Jains believe in moksha, salvation, or freedom from the cycle of births and rebirths. Mahavir preached equality and was opposed to the caste system. Teachings of Buddha. Four Noble Truths. According to Buddha, the world is full of suffering. The suffering has a cause. Desire is the cause of suffering. And if desire is stopped, suffering can also be stopped. This could be done by following the Eightfold Path. It is a path midway between luxurious living and hard penance. Next one we'll be dealing here is Nirvana. The ultimate goal of life is to attain Nirvana, or salvation. It is a peaceful state of mind which conquers all diseases, makes the person free from the cycle of birth and death. Buddhism also believes in the karma theory, equality, and universal brotherhood. Buddha is silent on the existence of God. With this, we end this video. I hope you must have liked it. Thank you.